It's called Beauty in Essex. It's also a lounge. It's at the Cosmopolitan in Las Vegas. He's in the Big Apple this morning for some great grilling. I love all of the dishes that you're preparing. But I first want to ask you, in addition to all of your other things, you're the spokesperson for Vegas. You say great destination in the summer.
Amazing. You know, I actually just got back yesterday from 2 straight months in Las Vegas getting Beauty in Essex open. And I got to tell you, it's such a spectacular, fascinating city. There's so much to do. The shopping, the nightlife, you know, the best DJs in the world play there. Pool parties in the summer, which is why you should go now. The pool parties, you'll never believe how much fun you can
have. I've heard Vegas might be a little fun.
It's so much fun. Yeah. And so many great restaurants. I mean, it's
including
just really amazing.
Beauty and Essex,
including
which
Beauty
if you've
Essex.
Never been to it in New York City, is a very big hot spot.
Yeah, we've been really lucky, really popular since we opened here, and we're at the Cosmopolitan, which I think is the perfect spot for
it's
us.
It's a very cool hotel.
Yeah, the synergy between our look and feel and their look and feel is great.
I mean, I just have to, Jesse, I can hear you chewing down there. Jesse is already mowing the meal.
Yeah, we're busy.
But yeah, Vegas is so much fun.
Yay to
summertime
Vegas,
especially.
Yay to grilling. Chef
let's
Chris,
go.
Let's talk about
all right, so
what
grilling.
We're making.
So we're going to do a signature item, actually, that's on the Beauty in Essex menu in both New York and Vegas.
This is a flatbread?
It's
is it hard to make?
No, it's a high-gluten flour, just like 4 or 5 ingredients. You can also always go to your favorite pizza shop and just ask them for
some dough,
to be honest,
which is what I do with my kids. It's fun. What's your sauce? It doesn't look like true red sauce.
It's a San Marzano tomato sauce, but we make a very concentrated tomato oil. Simple recipe, which I'm sure you can get online.
Yes, we have it on our website.
But that really concentrates the tomato flavor. Something to think about with the dough. You want to part grill it in advance.
Okay.
So like this is part grilled. As you can see, we have some part grilled here.
A little bit of throw it back
so all you do
tomato
is,
sauce, a little olive oil. Yeah. Then you add the cheese.
And you want to do that on high heat both times, so it's a real quick cook.
This is a ricotta?
This is burrata.
Ah. Yeah. You know what I was trying to sound like a foodie?
Yes.
I was so lame.
And you'll know I'm not even trying to make you get your hands dirty because you got that pretty dress on.
Thank you. I'll do part two.
So then this goes right on the grill.
There you see it.
This guy comes off.
Voila, the magic of TV.
This guy comes off, right? The magic of television.
And then this part I can handle.
That part you can handle.
Unless
you can switch.
So great for kids to add the secret vegetable.
Crispy eggplant, very simple.
I got the wrong cheese.
What did you say?
I said zucchini.
No,
these don't look
it's
big
eggplant.
Enough to be eggplant, but
crispy eggplant.
So they're smaller.
It's a Japanese eggplant. That's
but
why
you could
it's smaller.
Do it with zucchini if you want.
You could.
I'm just saying.
You could also bread a whole bunch of these in advance and freeze them, and you'll have them ready to go at any time.
It's divine, Jesse. I know
little
you already
eggplant.
Ate yours.
Okay.
Would you like it?
Ginger is actually beating me right now in the food race, but absolutely, we're giving
then
it
because
the two
thumbs up. I like to cook healthy. A second cheese, right?
Okay.
A second cheese, a little burrata. I'm sorry, a little whipped ricotta rather. You're going to top that with some basil, some Parmesan cheese.
And we are done.
Delicious, right?
You have two other dishes that you brought, and we are running out of time.
We're running out of time already?
So let's talk about the mac and cheese.
All right, mac and cheese. Braised short rib jalapeno mac and cheese.
Short rib.
Is it good? Yeah.
This looks like it could be complicated.
That looks delicious. I mean, look at this. Get a shot of that. How delicious is that?
Yeah.
It's not. Bechamel sauce, little very, very basic cheese sauce, some pickled jalapenos, braised short rib. Some breadcrumbs.
Nice little kick to it. Enough. Yeah. Really
and then the third dish that will be on our website is your corn dish. What
right.
Is that?
So that's the riff on a Mexican style street corn called elote, but I actually do take it off the cob and saute it with lime, cilantro, chili, a little lime mayonnaise.
What's
your favorite?
Of course, the corn. The corn's
like
my favorite
pizza,
by far.
The chewiness of the pizza.
I'm very proud of you.
Thank you so
you
much.
You can now have dessert. Chris Santos, we thank you so
thank
much.
Thank you.
I'm eating with my mouth full.
Come see me in Vegas.
I will. All the recipes. Good morning, America.